Songwriter, producer, musician, you play at least four instruments and have been known to rock the bass upside down. How did you get started in music, Chris Walker?
Well, I got started in music. We had a family gospel group called the Walker Brothers, my dad and my brothers, and basically we toured around singing quartet gospel music, and that's how I pretty much got my start. I started singing at the age of five. And my father put the bass in my hand upside down because the other musicians stopped showing up for rehearsal. And he put my finger on a note and said, "This is a G, now watch me." And that's how I started playing the bass upside down.
Wow. So your dad got you started.
Yes, he got me started.
What instruments do you play?
I play the bass, the lead guitar, piano, and drums.
I know that you have worked as music director for living legend Al Jerreau and for Regina Belle during the height of her career. So it takes a very special musical ear for that role, music director. How did these opportunities and that exposure to the industry in that way help influence your artistry?
Wow. Well, needless to say, I mean, I was a huge Al Jerreau fan, and I still am to this day. But working with him on a daily basis and just having the opportunity to explore inside of his head and what he's thinking from an artist's perspective, it taught me a whole lot, not only about the business, but musically, how to approach certain songs vocally and as a bass player as well. So, I mean, he's been very instrumental in my development over the years. And, of course, working with Regina Belle, learning, stage presence and how to project. I mean, because actually with Regina, that's when I figured out or realized or discovered my voice, and that singing was what I definitely wanted to do. And I'll give you an example one time. We were opening for Maze and Frankie Beverly. We were touring with him. And she couldn't come to soundcheck one day for whatever reason. And the venue was maybe a 12,000-seat venue. So they asked me to check her microphone for her. So when I stepped up and I sang in her mic and I heard my voice in that auditorium, I said, "This is it. This is what I want to do." So I actively started pursuing a solo career as a vocalist, which has led to where I am today.
Your first album produced two hits that crossed over to top 30 on the pop charts. Why do you think "Giving You All My Love" and "Take Time" were so well received and resonated with listeners?
Well, you know, I think "Giving You All My Love," which was the first single that I came out with, I was probably 22 when that came out, and basically it's a sensual song that speaks to women. And I, at the time, because I was a very shy guy back then, I said, if I could say what I wanted to say to a woman without being shy, what would I say? And the lyrics to that song is what came out. And I just think it's if you listen to the lyric, it sounds like it's vulgar, but it's done in a tasteful manner, and like in a respectful manner. So I think that appealed to women, and they just kind of gravitated to it. And "Take Time," you know, that song is just an upbeat, uplifting type song, and just simply telling the woman, you know, "Take time, show me that you love me." And I think men can identify with that because we probably say that to women all the time. So, you know how y'all get busy sometimes and just forget about a brother, but that's okay. We still love y'all. So, you know, we have to let y'all know every now and then, just take time, show me that you love me. So.
That's just it. That's by me. Well, then, after the success of those two hits, for years, you stepped away from the mic to create music behind the scenes for other artists. But now you're in the zone, which is also the title for your new album.
That's
your first single, Yeah, your first single, I Got That Love, like I said, it knocks. It has some bump behind it. So tell me more about the album. What can your fans expect, and what can new fans look to enjoy?
You know, let me tell you, I took a different direction on this CD. It's still Chris, but I incorporated some of the old Chris with the new school vibe of today. And I tried to combine the elements and keep it lyrically interesting and melodically interesting, and, of course, from a chordal movement structure, keep it interesting for the listener as well. So, I mean, like one of the songs, I did a remake of Luther Vandross' song, If Only for One Night, and I've been performing it live, doing promotional things also, and the reception has just been incredible. And there are some other gems on there, too. Everyday Woman, which, you know, every woman, I think, can relate to that. Every woman that goes to work, that has kids, that are doing it on their own. And, you know, so that's a strong piece for women. And just a number of tunes that I think women and men will be able to relate to.
I'm sure your fans will be happy to have you back in the forefront. And soon they'll be able to catch you in a documentary about your life. Please tell the Queen's Castle readers more about the film and where we can see it.
You know, the film, there's a producer, his name is Andres Santamaria. He heard about my story when I moved to New York with $40 and a dream when I was 18, and I ended up, you know, landing a full scholarship to go to school. And, of course, there are a lot of struggles that come along with that. But I overcame the adversities to become the person that I am today. So when he originally approached me, I declined doing the documentary because I didn't. In my mind, I'm thinking, you know, I haven't really done enough to have a documentary. But after he presented it in that light to me, it changed my perception of it, and I said that's different. I like that, and I you know, if I can help other people and inspire them to chase their dream and follow it, then I'm all for it. So we've been working on it for about 2 years, and we've done maybe 40 to 50 interviews with various people that I've worked with in the industry, and we'll be finished hopefully by September, and it'll be available also. Just check my website, chriswalkermusic.com, and it'll have all the information where you can get it and view it, and we're actually going for Biography Channel and PBS.
What else can we look forward to from Chris Walker in the future?
Well, you can look forward to developing other artists and also constantly evolving as an artist myself and writing. But, you know, I just want to continue being able to produce quality music that people can put in their cars 20 years from now and say, wow, that still sounds good today. You know, and that's one of the things that inspire me because, you know, on YouTube, people, you know, they check out my videos that I've done in the past, and they've always been asking for years, when is he coming back? When is he coming back? So, you know, I've been watching and reading and listening, and I said, you know, now is a good time because the state of the music industry, I just think real singers, it's time for real singing to come back.
Absolutely it is. Mr. Walker, thank you so much for your time this afternoon. I know the Queen's Castle readers are going to go out and get zoned. We're all happy to have you back in the forefront on the mic delivering real music. Sir, it is my honor to tell you that you've been officially crowned.
Oh, thank you so much.